wish to thank the Ghana Badminton Association and especially the Ghana Olympic Committee, okay, to have accepted to hold this very, very important and crucial course for the development of badminton in Ghana. It must be noted that to get an Olympic solidarity course is not that easy. So I doubly thank the Ghana Olympic Committee for having been able to obtain this course for you people, because other events of fighting the Olympic solidarity course is not that easy. And we have had the backing of the Badminton World Federation to have this course here, due to that serious work that are being taken in Ghana. So it has been a pleasure for me to be around here, to run this course, and I've shown it to you. Whatever you have learned in this course, that's what is practiced at higher level. But there are things that we aim at down the ladder, is a development of the skills to motivate the pupils, okay? Things technically, tactically, and physically, what we have to look into. And at higher level, is totally different. But higher level is built on what you have learned here during these 4 days. There's nothing more. The difference there is mental, is physical, is technical, and also tactical. But that's what we have down here also. So once you get these things straight, it won't be difficult to have good players in Ghana. I assure you that whatever you have learned here on the manual, you have been given all the facilities. You have got the video clips for all the strokes you can imagine. Tactics, techniques, everything is there. You have got the manual, you've got guidelines, you have all the teaching methods, all the learning styles, stages of learning. You have gone through everything in a very scientific, systematic way. And especially teaching the young kids where we have pedagogy. Coaching is not winning everything, no. The pedagogical part is also important, how to motivate the pupils, to make them interested, to make them come to badminton. All right, that's very, very important. So this course is mainly based on these, so that we can get the best out of the child. So I think it's not only bookish. I've got a lot of my personal experience in Africa, in all the 15, 16 countries I've been going around, getting enriched. And this is what I've shared to you. You will see that most of the things I shared to you doesn't come from the book. It's practical application. That's what you should be doing. If you take that certificate and put it in your drawer or just put it on the wall there, you will never succeed as a coach. Try to put it into practice, what you have learned, review everything, go on internet. We have seen the role and responsibilities of the coach, where he has to improve himself, enrich his knowledge, share it with other coaches. All right, this is where you enrich yourself. So put into practice, then you will become a coach. You will be able to identify what to correct. The coaching eye is very, very important.